Hey guys, it's the Love Guru from loveguru.net and thealiennetwork.com and horsehealer.net, which I feel like I should say that. I think it's .net. Is it horsehealer.net or .com? I think it's .net. I don't even know my websites because I'm wearing my first horse shirt. Oh, I'm so excited. I'm going to order another one. Yeah, I'm a horse healer, so I'm excited about that. And you become obsessed with horses. I dream of horses, for real. They come in my dreams, and I see visions of them all the time. I want to talk to my New Jersey people, okay? This is a video specifically for New Jersey people, and if you have friends or family living in New Jersey, please forward them this video if you can think at any level that they can comprehend something in here, because I feel like things are just out of control here, and by out of control, I mean it's time for New Jerseyans, New Jerseyites. What do we call ourselves? I have no idea. It's time for those in New Jersey to wake up. We have been on lockdown for 3 months now. 3 months, or just about 3 months. At what point are those of us in New Jersey, because we're not called New Jerseyans and we're not called New Jerseyites. I have no idea what we're called. I'm sure people can make some jokes around that, but I'll just let it be. At what point are you going to start asking questions and being like, something is weird here. Every other state is open. We're the only state still closed, or maybe one of the only states. I think we're the only state that's closed. And if we carry on like this, we're going to be closed forever. Okay? Because listen, at what point are you going to realize like, hey, I'm not afraid of this virus anymore, you know? Like maybe this lockdown is actually not about public safety. It's maybe about control. Maybe it's about corruption. Maybe our governor is corrupt. Have you noticed Cuomo? Like, I know that's in New York, but he's super corrupt. And I feel like it's super obvious his corruption. Him and his brother, I think it is. Whatever their relationship is. The two Cuomos, I'm looking forward to them getting arrested. And Governor Murphy's going to be arrested. These people are corrupt. We have corrupt politicians. It is time for New Jersey people to wake up and to start standing up for your rights. I know this is not our programming. This is not our training. But if you've watched any sort of footage out there, and I think this is alternative media, you can't watch. So maybe I should give a little bit of a lesson, okay, to my New Jersey people. You know, I love New Jersey. I grew up in New Jersey. I'm a Jersey girl. I had plans of staying in the state, but people are so asleep and so programmed and so brainwashed that it's very emotionally, mentally difficult for me to be around here. So New Jersey people, and I'll say New York, we are highly educated, okay? And I like that. I like that about us. I love it. But along with that high education is that it means that you're really thick in the brainwashing. And granted, everybody is brainwashed. We're all programmed since we're young. But the brainwashing that we have is get good grades, go to a good college, get good grades there, do a lot of extracurricular, get a good job, and then make that money, right? And many people around here are just in that hamster wheel of, you know, you're just a rat in the rat race. You wake up, you go to work, you make money, you come home. Like, it's just all about the money, all about the prestige. And fine, I'm not saying anything is wrong with that, okay? I like that too. Although I don't really live that lifestyle. I like it. I have that programming too. Listen, I was raised here, okay? That's what it's all about here. Money making Manhattan. Like, that name didn't just come out of the blue. Like, that is what it's all about. And that's what makes New York City great. But the thing is that if you look around at these other states, and they have their own programming, but if you look at North Carolina, South Carolina, Texas, these people are fighting for their rights. They're all about the Constitution, right? You know, they're all about their guns. They're all about free speech. They're all about, like, let me open my business. People have been getting arrested. They've been having protests. They've been speaking out about something shady going on with this virus. In New Jersey, I hear crickets. And it's not the good kind of crickets, like when you're out in the forest or like a more suburban area. I live kind of more in the city area right now. But you know that you're living and you're hearing like the crickets at night. I love that sound. I'm not talking about that. I'm hearing crickets as in no one is protesting here. The only thing that people protest here is the George Floyd hoax, the supposed death, the Black Lives Movement, which is a phony movement. So this is where you have to start using your education for your own good, to empower yourself of what's really going on, okay? The virus was a bioweapon that was planted to depopulate, okay? The George Floyd, quote, death was a staged event. The guy's not dead, okay? Now you might say, Blair, this is conspiracy stuff. And fine if you want to call that. It's called truth. I'm not using that word conspiracy anymore because, again, if you do any research, if you educate yourself, not using mainstream media, that is controlled. Mainstream media is controlled by the CIA. I'm kind of giving you a real basic breakdown of education to kind of like give you little samples to whet your palate so that you start doing some real research, all right? And it's not with mainstream media, not CBS, ABC, NBC, Fox, whatever. Just turn off all that shit. Go look on the computer, go look on the internet, and you have to really dig these days because we have censorship really bad. That's our First Amendment, okay? You should be speaking up about this. This should be annoying to you. This should be irritating to you. Oh, well, it's Blair. It's fake news. No, no. It's actually real news. It's real news. This alternative media, this conspiracy theorist, that's real news. What you're watching on ABC, NBC, CBS, Fox, on and on, all those channels, that's fake news. That's what they're using to brainwash you. It's all going to come out very soon, but do your research now because this is a big topic. Use your education for your good. It's time to get curious about what's really going on in the world, okay? It's time to get curious about who our supposed leaders are. It's time to start questioning these things. So, what else do we want to share here? I'm just making this video because I love New Jersey. I don't know if I could possibly stay in this state because it's just... We all have programming, but I feel like this state can possibly be on lockdown forever because I don't think that anybody would ever say anything in New Jersey. So you might not be unhappy, but you might be unhappy, but it's time to get into your power to start being like, I'm not happy with this. All right. It's not about protesting the Floyd killing, getting upset about cops. It's not about that. That is a smokescreen. That's an illusion. Don't feed into the illusion. Look at what's really going on here. It's about corruption. It's about control. And Spirit wants me to share this. I am doing these teaching sessions one-on-one, or if you get a group of people, I will meet with you through phone, Skype, or in person. But again, I feel like a lot of people are still afraid in New Jersey to meet in person. You could wear your damn mask if you want. You can keep 6 feet distance. You could do all that. Whatever makes you happy, you can do. I'm not going to be wearing a mask if we meet in person, okay? And that's in New York City. That's in New Jersey. I don't wear a mask. I never wore a mask. I don't even have a mask, okay? I don't do that because I have educated myself as to what's really going on. And I have educated myself on how to keep myself healthy. You know, you can build your immune system that you are so healthy that it doesn't matter what you come in contact with. You're still strong, okay? There's supplements you could learn about. There's everything. There's exercise you could do. There's sunlight you can get. There's a lot of all this alternative. It's such a big topic. I'm not going to go into it here. If you want to learn, if you want me to catch you up to speed as far as this New World Order, that's what it's all, the big umbrella, that's what it's under, New World Order. If you want me to catch you up to speed and educate you, fill in the blanks. If you know some information about this, but you're missing some stuff, again, it's a big topic. I have spent the last 10 years of my life studying this. And by studying, I mean I have spent hours upon hours, days upon months upon whatever years, whatever the saying is, I have done it like a full-time job. For real. For real. So much so that family members were concerned about me because I studied this stuff so much. Well, look at how it comes into play here, because this is part of my mission. Part of my mission is helping deprogram people. And that's what you need. You need a deprogramming to step out of the illusions and into the real truth of what's going on in this world. And most of the time, people do not give a rat's ass about what's going on in the world, and they only care what's going on in their own life. But now you see on how the collective, what's going on out there, is actually affecting your life. It is time to be vigilant, to know what's going on, to be awake of that, to start looking at these other states on how they were protesting. I'm sure those videos are still up about how these other states, people were protesting about that they wanted their rights. You know, start looking at the Constitution. What are your constitutional rights? Is it even constitutional to require you to wear a mask? Well, Blair, I'm afraid. Well, this is another area of healing that I can help you with. It's the healing around taking you out of illusions, breaking you out of illusions. People call it breaking out of the matrix. And then the second level of breaking you out of the matrix is which is healing the fears that you have, the anxieties. You know, I emailed the lady, my hairdresser, and I don't know if she saw the email because it was through Facebook. I don't know if she saw the email or she's just afraid to disobey the rules. I have a lot of people in the area where I live that are afraid of disobeying the rules or afraid of getting arrested. How can you live that way? That is you giving away your power. So back to what I was saying, I'm doing these deprogramming teaching sessions. They're teaching sessions. They're half an hour, they're 150 at this time. It's very low to catch you up on speed, up to speed as far as what's going on and to start putting you in your power. Because you know what? Again, New Jersey, New York people, I love you guys. I moved back up here because I loved it. It was just in my heart and soul. You know, you can't get New York City, that feeling, that New Jersey feeling, you can't get it out of your soul. It just pulls you back. So I need to help my people out here. You guys need to start waking up. I know Governor Murphy's going to make another announcement about the slow reopening of our state, but he's one man. He's one man. We're a huge population, this state. And I need to give a little push. I need to give a little wake-up call. I mean, I still see so many people wearing masks. I still see people so afraid of getting close to someone else, touching someone else, afraid of breaking the rules. This is all the way you have been programmed. Do you want to continue living your life like this? Giving away your power, being afraid of people, being afraid of people in positions of, quote, power. They're just, it's one person. Granted, it's a big chain of corruption, but at the end of the day, these people are weak. I'm going to leave it at that. If you would like me to give you, to share with you a teaching of what's going on, I can share links with you. I have a lot of stuff that I have been guided to save on my computers to back up because they take it down of YouTube, that I can give you an education and catch you up to speed of what's really going on in the world. It's not the virus and it's not the protests around Floyd, and it's not the riots around Floyd. It's not that. Stop looking at surface level shit. Go deeper than that. So I can catch you up to speed, okay? It's 150 for 30 minutes, phone, Skype, in person. I'm over in the Clifton area. If you want to come to me, you can come to me. Contact me to get a payment link. And if you have a group of people, I would love to speak in front of you and to share this information. Okay. I can't just sit around and just watch anymore. I can't. It just bothers me too much. You know, people, when this virus started happening, people were interested and curious and thinking that it was weird, and people were open to listening to the message. Now people have totally shut down and they're all wrapped up in, I don't know what the thought process is, but I just can't sit around and watch as my fellow New Jersey man and woman, my fellow brothers and sisters here are just so submissive. That's not us. You know, we're the ones who have the attitudes. We speak up about things. It's time to start speaking up. I don't think we've had one protest about the virus. Oh, Blair, why are you still talking about the virus? The virus, we're over that now. Well, it's coming back. It's coming back. How does a virus come back? Huh? You gotta ask that. How do the powers that be make viruses come and go magically? My website's loveguru.net. If you want to get in touch, if you'd like to have a session, a teaching session, I really would like to do an outreach to teachers, to those on the police force. It's time to, so if you have a connection there, if you're listening to this and you are a teacher in the school system, I need to speak with you. And if you're open to this, I need to speak with you. This next round of the virus, they're coming after kids, okay? Being a school teacher is going to be important to be awake school teacher that knows what's going on. I'm not talking about wake. I'm like, oh, I'm not sleeping anymore. I'm talking about awake, that you are vigilant, that you know what's going on, that you're aware of the corruption, that you're aware of how they're trying to manipulate us. You need to be aware of these things. So I want to speak to groups. If you're a police officer in that department, invite me in. I want to come in and speak to your troops. Or your police force, whatever it's called, the military around here. I mean, it's like, please spread around this video. Please share it with anyone who's even remotely, if you're just sort of hazy awake, questioning a little bit, maybe something's a little bit weird here. Oh, I want to get enlightened to what's going on, please. Share this message. Invite me to your home, or we'll meet at the park or your backyard. And I will share this information. I will bring, I will point you in the direction of videos and articles. And again, I am a hardcore researcher. I have questioned this stuff and analyzed this stuff and studied this stuff for 10 years of my life. And again, periods that this was the only thing I did day and night. It is a deep, dark hole. It's not a short conversation. Loveguru.net is where you can find me. If you have horses, I would be happy. Look at how my hair's wet. I need a haircut. I am not going to a hair salon if I need to wear a mask. Like I said, I don't even have a mask. I'm not doing that. More people need to speak out about this. You need to get the statistics as far as how many people really did die and how they alter the numbers and all of this stuff. Study more. This is what you should be doing at this time, studying. Don't just go back into the routine that, oh, I'm just working from home now. That's not what this was all about. This was about raising your awareness, going to a higher level of consciousness. This is about evolving your soul, growing your soul. We have a soul. You're not just a human being going to work, making money, just worried about your kids. You are a soul that is here on this earth for something related to humanity. You have a mission. There's something bigger, the reason why you're here. Okay, that's it. I'm done. Thank you for watching. Thank you for sharing. I love you guys. New Jersey, please, I love you. Please step it up, New Jersey. New York City, please step it up. I love you guys. I love it here. I want to stay in my town, in my area, in my land. This is my land. Okay.